My name is Carlos. Carlos, and I am a Christian. So my question is, in Christian, we have Old Testament and New Testament Bible, and which one should I read and should I trust more?
The brother asked a very good question. He's a Christian, and he said there is Old Testament, there is New Testament. Which should he trust? Whether there is Old Testament, there is New Testament. There is also something called as the Last Testament. Last Testament, Quran. Who's saying that? Not Dr. Zakir Naik. Dr. Zakir Naik in Islam is zero. Who says that? Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. If you read the New Testament, as a Christian, according to your church, you have to follow both. Only following, if you read the Bible, Bible is divided into two parts, the Old Testament and New Testament. The Old Testament talks about stories of the prophets right from Adam, peace be upon him, till before Jesus, peace be upon him. New Testament talks about the life of Jesus, peace be upon him, onwards. But a Christian, if he does not follow the Old Testament, he will not be able to follow the New Testament, because only if we believe the Old Testament will he agree with the prophecies of Jesus Christ's coming. So as a Christian, according to the church, you should follow Old Testament and New Testament. Now when you follow Old and the New Testament, in the New Testament, Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, I have many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall show you things to come. He shall glorify me. He shall not speak of himself. All that here shall he speak. He shall glorify me. This is Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, talking to his people. I have many things to say unto you, but you cannot understand them now. This is about 2000 years back. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that here shall he speak. He shall glorify me. This prophecy is about no one but coming of the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. It is not about Holy Spirit. It is about Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Because Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 7 says, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, it is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter shall not come. For if I depart, shall he come. Many Christians say this is Holy Spirit. If you read this prophecy, the criteria for the Holy Spirit, for the Comfort to come, is that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, should depart. If you read the Bible, the Holy Spirit was already there before Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was born in the womb of Elizabeth. He was there when Jesus was born. He was there at the Feast of Pentecost. So surely this prophecy doesn't refer to the Holy Spirit, but refers to the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is prophesied in several places in the Old Testament and the New Testament. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 18. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 19. In the book of Isaiah, chapter number 29, verse number 12. In the Song of Solomon, chapter number 5, verse number 16. He's even prophesied in the New Testament. In the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 16. In the Gospel of John, chapter number 15, verse number 26. In the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 7. As well as the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse 12 to 14. All these are references. I'm not pulling a fast one. You can go home and check. And all these prophecies are talking about a new messenger to come. The last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So if you ask me, should you follow Old Testament or New Testament? I will tell you, follow the Last Testament. That is the Quran. And who has said that? Old Testament is saying that. I gave you references. New Testament is saying that. I gave you references. Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, is saying. So if you are a good Christian, if you are a good follower of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, it is compulsory you should believe in Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. If you do not, that means you are not a good Christian. Brother, are you a good Christian? Yes or no? Brother, are you a good Christian? You don't know. Are you a good Christian or not?
Yes.
That means you have to follow the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. If Christian means a person who follows the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, we Muslims are more Christian than the Christian themselves. Brother, do you believe Jesus is a prophet of God or is God?
Jesus is a prophet.
MashaAllah, that means you're good. Even we believe Jesus is a prophet of God. Because Islam is the only non-Christian faith which makes it an article of faith to believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. We believe that he was one of the mightiest messengers of God. We believe that he was the Messiah, translated Christ. We believe that he was born miraculously without any male intervention. We believe that he healed those born blind and lepers with God's permission. The Christians and the Muslims, they are going together. But the difference is that most of the Christians, unlike you, MashaAllah, you are a good Christian. Unlike you, they say that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, claimed divinity. In fact, if you read the Bible, there is not a single unequivocal statement from the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that I am God, or where he says, worship me. If you point out a single unequivocal statement from anywhere in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that I am God, or where he says, worship me, I am ready to accept Christianity. In fact, if you read the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 28. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, my Father is greater than I. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 29. My Father is greater than all. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 28. I cast out devil with the Spirit of God. Gospel of Luke, chapter number 11, verse number 20. I with the finger of God cast out devil. Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30. I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just. For I seek not my will, but the will of my Father. Anyone who says, I seek not my will, but the will of Almighty God, is a Muslim. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was a Muslim. It's clearly mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22, that ye men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God amongst you by wonders and miracles and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. That means Jesus Christ, according to the Bible, peace be upon him, was a prophet of God. Unfortunately, the church teaches the Christian that is God. But nowhere it is mentioned in the Bible that is God. Even in the Quran, it says that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was one of the mightiest messengers of God. Good brother. Brother, you believe that Jesus is God, alhamdulillah. Do you believe that there is one God?
Yes.
MashaAllah. Do you believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God?
Yes.
You believe that?
Yeah.
Very good. There are minimum two criteria required for any human being to enter the fold of Islam. If any human being wants to become a Muslim, there are minimum two things required. One, if he should believe there is one God, and I gave the definition of God in my lecture. You should not believe Jesus is God, and you should believe that besides Jesus being a messenger of God, Prophet Muhammad is a messenger of God. So if you believe there is one God, and if you believe Prophet Muhammad is a messenger of God, that means according to me, you're a Muslim. To be a Muslim, you have to agree in these. Other things will follow later on. About following, about praying, will come later on. But first you have to take admission into the school. First you join nursery, then you can do first standard, second standard, third standard, tenth standard. So to take admission in the fold of Islam, you have to believe in two things. Believe that there is one God, and believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God. And you agree with both. Would you like to say it in Arabic? Would you like to say that in Arabic, that there is one God and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God? If you believe in these two things, that there is one God,
okay,
and you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, that means you are submitting your will to God. And a person who submits his will to God is called as a Muslim. Muslim doesn't mean having a name Zakir, Abdullah, Sultan, or Muhammad. Muslim means a person who submits his will to God. If he agrees there's one God, and if he agrees Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, these are the minimum two things required for a human being to become a Muslim. Later on, he will learn more and get more knowledge. But minimum these two things, if he agrees, he becomes a Muslim. Would you like to enter the fold of Islam? Would you like to say it in Arabic? Same thing, that there is one God and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God. Would you like to follow the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him?
But if I enter and convert to Muslim, I must learn about Muslim, right?
Yes. When you convert, once you become a Muslim, you have set the minimum two requirement. Then later on would come Salah, not from day one. And then, because we believe this life is a test for the hereafter. As Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, I have many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. For he, when the spirit of truth shall come, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will come, he will guide you to truth. So once you enter, slowly, slowly you learn and you practice. How you enter school, first you learn A, B, C, D, then C, A, T, CAT, B, A, T, BAT. Slowly, slowly, it takes time. Some people get double promotion, they learn fast also. Would you like to enter the school of Islam? You are thinking too much.
I'm not ready, sir.
Okay, fine. I would like you to do more study.
Yeah.
And once you're convinced, I would like you to enter the fold of Islam. To enter the fold of Islam, as I told you, minimum two things are required. Believe that there's one God and believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God. Later on, the practice comes. But as a good Christian, you have to follow the advice of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, that follow the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Inshallah, I'll pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you guidance as soon as possible. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.